We all know the planets of solar system be like. Four small rocky ones and four giant gaseous ones. And, one that is hard to explain. And just look at the size of the smallest gas giant and the biggest rocky planet in the solar system. You see a notable gap in size and you might think Neptune is the standard of being giant enough to be a giant. Although Neptune as well as Uranus are ice giants and is kind of different from gas giants like Jupiter and Saturn that mostly contain hydrogen and helium, they are still considered being gaseous. This gives them a low density, and they don't have a solid surface. Just like the feature of gas giants. So gaseous planets should be huge like Neptune at least. Right? However, when humans decided to look into space, they found exoplanets. They thought they might just discover more Mars, Saturn and Neptune, but unfortunately, those exoplanets goes way away away beyond the laws of solar system and slapped their face like a tennis. Basically, they found that one type of exoplanet is frequently being found in many star systems. They seem like gas giants, but way less massive than Neptune and Uranus. This is a very, very interesting discovery, as none of the planets in the solar system falls in this category. Unfortunately, humans give them a boring name.
Bruh.
Mini-Neptunes, sometimes aka gas dwarfs or transitional planets. To show some examples, HD 110067 is a tiny star like our lovely sun located some 105 light-years away from Earth, and it has 6 cute planets. 6 of them are mini-Neptunes. Wow, it's a mini-Neptune family, oh my gosh. These strange planets prove that not only planets with 10 times the mass of the Earth can look like strong gas giants. Even you see a planet which only has like 3 to 4 times the mass of the Earth, still. You may want to consider it as a gaseous planet before you get its radius and calculated its density. Sounds crazy? But that's how the universe works. Behold, the mini-Neptune. A cosmic creation that defies the norms and leaves astronomers scratching their heads. It's not your average planet, it's the rebellious teenager of the planetary family, trying to figure out its identity in the cold, dark expanse. Wait, that's not the case. Actually, many of the mini-Neptunes are orbiting fairly close to their home star and they are quite warm. Yeah. They are called mini-Neptunes just because they are smaller than Neptune, not necessarily means that they are introverts and orbiting far away from their sweet home stars. Okay, let's get back to the context. Resembling Neptune but lacking the gravitational swagger, it struts around with a thick atmosphere, probably hiding layers of oceans of who knows what beneath. These interstellar oddities play by their own rules, showcasing a blend of gases, frozen delights, and a sprinkle of cosmic mystery. Are there deep oceans of water? Perhaps. Liquid ammonia? Why not? A mix of both or something even wilder? The mini-Neptune keeps its secrets close, making it the cosmic enigma we never knew we needed. Oh, by the way, in terms of quantity, mini-Neptunes are even more common than hot Jupiters, although hot Jupiters are a famous type of exoplanets. What's even more confusing is that Neptune-like planets are considerably rarer than mini-Neptunes, despite being only slightly bigger. So if you're able to wander around the space, you'll see those kind of little things everywhere, in here and there of the galaxy, and they can be as small as 1/3 of the radius of the Neptune. Well, that truly describes the word mini. That actually brings a considerably more interesting question. Can we have a gas giant Earth? Can we have a gas giant moon perhaps? Well, to understand how small they can be, we have to know how they form in the universe. It's not mysterious though, I mean, just like most others, they start off firstly as a dense, hot, rocky core. Until they reach some sort of critical mass, then start to attract some lighter materials from the planetary disk. As a result, they become considerably more massive quickly and this gives them more gravity, until they end up with nothing left to attract around its orbital space, and that's when they stop growing further. Depending on their forming region and composition, they could be big or small before they stop growing. And apparently mini-Neptunes are the poor ones that just by sheer coincidence had not enough gas to consume. But they can't rewind back to rocky state anyway, so they became this weird, awkward dwarf gas balls. Or there were bad Jupiter bullies that hijacked their potential gas food, but you know what, becoming a mini-Neptune in this situation is already lucky. Otherwise, you get a Mars. Oh my gosh. But of course not any planet can develop towards a gas planet. It should form in a region that is far enough from star to ensure solar wind and thermal disruption won't stop light materials clumping around. And theoretically, if a mini-Neptune is unfortunate enough, it can be as small as the size of Earth and half as massive as the Earth. I think it's very interesting to see this type of planet being common in the universe. Just like most of us fail in something, most of gas planets also fail in developing further into ice giants and stronger gas giants, only to find themselves stuck at an awkward position. Stars with gas dwarfs tend to be slightly more metal-rich, while those with gas giants have up to 50% more metals than the Sun. It seems that there is a sweet spot of metallicity to get Earth-sized planets, and it's about the same as the Sun, and that makes sense. Because, at lower metallicities, you have fewer of the building blocks for planets, and at higher metallicities, you tend to make gas giants instead. Finally, in terms of habitability, there has been debate over whether these types of planets could host an environment that could be potentially habitable.
Hey! I guess you are habitable.
The problem is that a habitable zone mini-Neptune is expected to have a thick hydrogen envelope. Under this, there's thought to be a fluid ocean, but a really high-pressure one, depending on the thickness of the hydrogen envelope. The thicker the envelope, the denser the ocean. If it's dense enough, well, that means it's a no-go for life as far as we know. Anyway, we still know so little about these intriguing objects, but that's exactly the motivation for humans to look deeper into space. By digging into them, we learn more than just what we have known. Although, they don't have a chance to show up in the solar system. If you are interested in exoplanets and want to learn more about them, you might want to also check out this video over there.